been getting a lot of comments on my videos from a person called Aryan, who's a subscriber. He really wanted me to visit Flame and Grill. He mentioned in the comments that he's going to be here on Saturday exactly 1 o'clock to try out the buffet. So that is why Shinchan and myself are here. Let's give him a surprise. Alright guys, so we are settled in at Flame and Grill. This is at South City Mall, 3rd floor. And we are here waiting for Aryan to be here anytime. It's a surprise for him. While he comes, I'll quickly check out the menu, show you what the menu is like. So weekend, a Saturday, the price is $8.95 plus GST. On a normal weekday lunch, that is going to be 100 rupees less, which is $7.99 plus GST. Menu for the day is, you start off with the non-veg starters, which you have Amritsari fish, the mutton sheikh kebab, there's Peshawari tandoori chicken, there's Achari tandoori prawns, as well as the lal murg tikka. And then you have a lot of vegetarian starters as well. You have main courses, different types, chicken as well as fish, prawns, eggs, as well as biryani. For veg too, you have a lot of options. And finally, you have the desserts. There are 6 varieties of desserts over here. And I'm told that there is also a welcome drink, which is an aerated beverage.
And he is here.
Hi, Aryan.
Hello.
Come, join.
I didn't expect, sir.
Sit down. So this was a surprise planned for you.
Sir, I really didn't expect this.
That is the reason I did not comment on any of the comments. Which you, your friend is waiting right there, so you're going to join. You're going to join him.
Yes.
But for 2 minutes, we'd like to have you here. Definitely. So since when have you been following Foods for?
Whenever I see a person who is like in Kolkata, so you get like you want to subscribe the channel, and you and your channel was the only channel which I resonated a little bit more.
Okay.
So that is it.
So what do you do?
Right now, so I'm a student at Amity University.
Amity University.
So
which year?
First year.
First year. You're a foodie?
Big foodie.
Big time foodie.
Big foodie.
So I think what we'll do is today, since you have a plan with your friend already,
yes,
you're
yes.
going to join him.
Yes.
But we'd love to have you over sometime and
yes,
join us over the meal
itself.
Yes,
right.
Lovely meeting you.
Thank you, sir. Nice meeting you, sir. Thank you.
Shy boy. So what we're going to do is finally Shinchan is giving me the stare. So what we're going to do is we're going to call for the starters, because I am not, but Shinchan definitely is famished. Starters, here are the grills. What I'll do is I'll just let me start with the prawns first. Next up, the fish. The chicken. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to review the first few items, starting with the corn. Crispy, it's not very dry, it's pretty juicy inside, but it's very very oily, so I'm not going to recommend this one. Next up, we have the fish kebab. Fish is pretty good, it's juicy, moist inside, pretty flavorful outside, it's marinated well, it's pretty nice. Next up, we have the prawns, the shell. I like the fact that the prawn is not overcooked. It's been given in such a way that even if it's lying on the grill for 5 minutes, it's not going to ruin the taste. Prawn is pretty good. At least the first helping is. Finally, we have the chicken. The chicken looks pretty basic. I love the fact that it has a smoky taste. It's pretty good. Now I'm going to finish off all the remaining vegetarian starters. So we're going to be having the aloo. We'll be having the pineapple. That's my favorite. If the pineapple na ho, I'm going to go. We'll be having paneer, which is Shinchan's favorite. And finally, mushrooms. These are button mushrooms. Try out the aloo first. It's pretty soft. That's my bite. Pretty good. The paneer is soft too. Mushrooms. The mushroom has a sour taste. I'm not a fan of that. I like my mushrooms to be creamier. The pineapples. This is the final starter of the day, which is a mutton sheep. It's slightly under seasoned, but of all the items which I've tried from the buffet, this actually clearly is the best one. Not that any of the items were bad. All of them are pretty decent, but honestly, I've tried a lot of buffets over the years, and even recently I've tried a couple, and both the buffets which I tried before this were better than this, at least where the starters was. Definitely the ambience is amazing, the service is pretty good, which you expect from a brand like this. Expected something better, because this is by some margin the priciest of the buffets which I've tried over the past couple of months post the pandemic. So I'm slightly disappointed comparing it with the others and comparing it with itself, since it's such a big brand. So we now have the main courses ready in front of us. I have my favorite non-vegetarian main courses on my right and the vegetarian main courses on my left. And there's biryani, so that you know it weighs equal, and there is roti over here. So let's start with maybe a spoon each of these first. So I'm taking a spoon of dal. I won't be having the entire thing. This is not dal, this is anda. Pretty hard. So I'm gonna take my anda here. I'm gonna take Shinchan's favorite paneer item. That's it. From here, I'll be taking the prawn. The reason I'm not mentioning the exact names of items is because it keeps varying every day. So what is important that you know what are the different types of non-veg items they're giving, because that stays the same. For instance, today the preparation of the prawn might be something else, tomorrow it might be something else, but you know that there's going to be a prawn item for main course, so that is more important. This is a chicken chop. Now this might be there every day, so I can mention the name. I'll take one piece of this with a little bit of gravy. Fish main course. That's what I'm taking. Now to have it, I'm gonna take a naan. That should be enough. So barring the biryani, this is what my main course platter looks like. So I'm gonna try all the items and I'm gonna give you a review. So let's start with the dal first. Pretty creamy, it's pretty good. Next up, I'll have the egg. I won't have the egg with the bread, I'll have it directly. Next, I'll have the paneer. The paneer items are good over here. prawn, I'm not going to have it with the bread. I'm going to have the prawn directly. There is an option of steamed rice, but I'm not going because I'm already full. So I'll just try the prawn item by the way. Next up, I'm having the chicken. So it's a very homely preparation of chicken with chop which they have. You won't find it to be very masala enough. It's something which is a little homely. Milder version of a chop. And finally I'll have it with the fish. That's my plate of biryani. It's pretty white in color, slightly greasy in texture. That's my bite. There's one thing I'd like to mention about the main courses over here. Outwardly, you might not find the items to be very flavorful or very burstful of taste, etc. But what I like about the main courses over here is that it's all of the items have been made pretty mild. So it's not going to be very heavy on your stomach. You won't find yourself to be very full or bloated up. It's pretty easy on your stomach. So for someone like me, who has food outside round the clock, 7 days a week, 30 days a month, I personally like the main course over here, not because it's very tasty or very flavorful, but because it's pretty mild, easy on the stomach, and that's what we expect from a place like this. So we have the final bits, the desserts. So you have pastries, brownies, halwa, gulab jamun, as well as some kheer. I'll start with the one which according to me is the least sweet. I'm confused between the halwa and the kheer. Judging by my past experience at buffets, it has to be this one. So, wow, it's very, very nice. Consistency is good. It's not overly sweet. Pretty good. Next, I'll have the halwa. Pretty decent. The brownie. The brownie is very good. It's not dry. It's got a lot of almonds and chocolate chips inside. It's pretty good. The pastry. The pastry is pretty light. Not very sweet. Fluffy. Pretty good. Gulab jamun. The gulab jamun is not hot, it's cold, so that's one disappointment. But other than that, the desserts, they might not be packing you with too many options, but whatever they've given, it all tastes good. Mind you, everything is unlimited. Don't go by the portions which I've taken. I don't like stuffing myself too much at buffets, as you would know by now. But whatever we've eaten, everything, barring the drinks, is unlimited. So that was my experience at Flavin Grill. Like I've mentioned already, the starters were a little disappointing taste-wise. But the main courses were pretty good because it was very easy on my stomach. I like main courses which are not too rich. So that kind of worked well for me. It might not for all of you. So you need to decide very carefully. If you like very flavorful, rich items, then this might not be the buffet for you. But if you're a fan of light meals and good service, good ambience, then definitely you can give this one a try. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do the same. Until next time, this is Foodspire myself wrapping up from South City Mall. Cheers!
Are you Arvind? Not Arvind.
So what I'm going to do is first I'm going to scan the menu from here. So you'll find a normal scanner option on a normal phone. Phone is that. The internet on kore dibi na.